Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Today I am going to show you details about Trimble C3 total station. You can see this is 5 second accuracy Trimble C3 autofocus model. Since this has got a function of autofocus, it is mentioned on model 2. This is a vertical lock and you can see it's locked, and this is slow motion screw. Similarly, this is a horizontal lock for horizontal angle lock, and this is for slow motion. This model comes in optical and laser plummet option, and you can see it. This is our optical plummet type. You can order laser plummet as well. This model has special features of taking two batteries at a time. This is called hot swappable battery. This is very useful features a total station has kept. We know when total station gets older, then the battery starts getting discharged rapidly. Sometimes while surveying, the data might get lost due to sudden shutdown of the device. By these features, if one battery gets nil, then automatically it operates with the other one, or you can operate by using single battery at a time as well. Now other brand total stations are also starting to keep these features. This is very useful features. Now let's get deeper into the device. Let me power on the device first. You can see details is shown in the screen and electronic power layer. Since this model has got no any plate or circular bubble on upper side, you can see there is no any bubble details, so we need to adjust using electronic bubble. Okay, now the number must be kept below 10 seconds. Just try to keep as low as possible. The lesser you keep, the more precise the data it gives. Let's skip this, and you can directly go to electronic bubble pressing shortcut key here also. Okay, you can see under 0 there is a bubble symbol, and by pressing it you can directly go to bubble, and the next is autofocus option. Now you can see it here. This is the main display page here. You can see DSP icon there, and there is page details. There are 4 pages, and this is first page. By pressing DSP key, you can change this to second, third, and fourth page respectively. Okay, now let's discuss about page 1. Here you can see details of HA, BA, horizontal angle, vertical angle, slope distance. This slope distance can be changed to horizontal distance and vertical distance. Now let's get to second page. Okay, here you can see it, horizontal angle, vertical distance, and horizontal distance. Now to third page, there is a horizontal angle to from counterclockwise direction. Second is vertical, this is slope gradient. This is very useful for surveying of irrigation and road. Okay, you can see if I tilt the telescope, it changes. Okay, the third one is of horizontal distance. Okay, now let's get back to fourth page. Okay, let me press here. There is coordinate details, stick nothing, and elevation. And below down, there is a point ID and height of target. It is useful while surveying from coordinate by recording data. Okay, we'll see that on later. Okay, now let me press display and go to first page. Now let's discuss about the physical key button. Escape, yes, it refers to escape, and it takes one step back for the process you have proceeded. The next one is measure 1 and measure 2 key. By default, measure 1 refers to measurement through prism mode, and measure 2 refers to non-prism mode, but it can be changed as per our requirement. Okay, for changing, if we press long on a particular key, let me press on measure 1. Okay, you can see it, the target details, prism constant, mode. Okay, now if I press left right key, you can see target is changed to non-prism. Okay, now if I press enter and get back, And if I will measure, now it will give me the measurement by using non-prism. Okay, you can see it. Okay, let me get back to features. Okay, now I'll keep it to prism. Now this is prism constant, it's usually 30 mm. Okay, now it's mode of measurement. You can see there are different option for measuring mode. You can keep as per your requirement. Okay, now let me keep it to precision, 1 mm. Okay, the average, it means at a particular point how many times do you need to measure and give the average of that point. Okay, record mode is there are three options: measure, confirm, and all. By measure, it only measures at a time and stop. By confirm, it measures and go to record features. And by pressing all, it will measure and record automatically. We will see it later while doing survey using coordinate system. Okay, now let me keep it to measure mode. Okay, escape. Now let me go to measure 2 option as well. Now you can see that is non-prism constant is 0. For non-prism mode, it's normally 0. Okay, now other. Okay, now let me go to display features. You can see there are option to change the display front display details. As I have said you earlier, the display icon can be changed. Now let me change slope distance to horizontal distance or vertical distance. You can see it can be changed as per your requirement, so I'll keep it by default as slope distance. Okay, others can be changed accordingly. Okay, let me press back to escape. Now going to angle mode, you can see there are zero set function, input function. Now if I press zero set, my horizontal angle can be changed to 0 degree. You can see there's 0 set and 1 number, so directly pressing 1 gives me 0 degree. Okay, you can see. Now second one is input. You can input certain angle as per your requirement. Okay, now I'll press 2 and I'll set at 60 degree. You can see now my angle will display at 60 degree. Okay, you can change as per your requirement. Okay, this is it about this button. The mode, this mode changes alpha to numeric and numeric to alpha while inputting name or something. Okay, now the menu is main features. We will see it later. Now this is shortcut key for illumination and laser light power on and power off. You can see it by pressing it. You can see it. 1 number is for illumination, 2 number is for laser light, 3 number is for beep sound, and 4 is for reticle illumination. Okay, you can change as per the requirement. Let's go to menu function. Okay, let me press menu. Now you will see different icon here. First we will go to setting to change different unit and other. Okay, going to angle, you can see it, vertical angle 0 to azimuth compass. You can keep it as per a requirement. Now distance, let it be as default. Now to coordinate, you can change order to NEZ, ENZ as per a requirement. Communication is used for transferring data, stack up unit. Now you can see it. Now angle unit is kept to degree, go, mil. It can be converted as per your site requirement. Now distance to meter, that US feet, inch, extra, temperature, and other. Now let's go to others. Okay, you can see it. Different, there are different setting option. You can change as per your requirement. It's not a big deal. Okay, now